Don and I arrived in Cuba on Friday, and the next day he and I indulged in a little sightseeing in Havana. And this was a real treat for me, as I rarely get to do much sightseeing when I go to Africa. As we went around the city, there were a couple of places that just seemed to scream out to me to stop and do a brief devotional there. One was at a famous cemetery, which was filled with some of the largest and the most ornate gravestones I've ever seen. The other was at a small park, which had, of all things, a statue of John Lennon. Well, we've been touring what has to be one of the largest cemeteries in the world. I've never seen such a large cemetery, and there are statues everywhere. People spend a lot of money to erect these statues and these various crypts that are in this cemetery. A lot of people are nervous about death. They don't like to think about it, don't like to see it. They don't want to go near a cemetery. But for the Christian, it's a different story, because the Bible says so much about resurrection and about eternal life that we don't fear death. In fact, Paul even mocked death. He said, "Oh, death, where is your sting? Oh, Hades, where is your victory?" And Jesus Christ said, "I'm the resurrection and the life. He that believes on me, though he were dead, yet shall he live, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die." So as a believer, this doesn't bother me in the least. Am I going to a place like this? Well, if Jesus tarries, it probably won't be nearly so fancy, but yeah, I'm going into a grave myself in a few years or 10 years, whatever it is, only God knows. But I don't fear that, because Jesus said, "He that believes in me is going to live forever." And there's only been one expert on life and death in this whole world. There's only been one person, whoever came from beyond, who came from the heavenly realm and lived among men, and that is Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. And he came and declared some very powerful things about life, about death, about forgiveness, about eternal life. And he said, "Believe in me, be changed, be born again, and you will live forever." Well, here in Havana, Cuba, this is the last thing you would ever think you would see, and that is a statue of John Lennon. I don't know why. I suppose his music was popular here in Cuba, but he is not a big idol of mine, I can tell you that. He is known mostly for his song called Imagine, and he describes a place where there's no heaven, there's no hell, and he acts like, wouldn't that be wonderful if there was no God, there was no devil, no heaven, no hell? But my thought is, would it really be wonderful to think that life is an accident, has no purpose, and then when we die, we're all going to go into the ground and be eaten by worms? Would that really be such a wonderful place? So John was an artist. He was a great musician, a great songwriter. He had a lot of talent, but in spiritual matters, he was quite foolish. And it is interesting. One story a lot of people don't realize, he actually contacted a Christian minister who was on television not so long before he died and apologized for declaring that the Beatles were more popular than Christ. He came to feel bad about that statement. So at least he recognized that much.